this chapter parts of class. Okay, yeah. In the last class, we have revised the objective question of this chapter. Today, we are going to revise the diagram of this chapter. First, we are going to show by this picture the parts of plants. Okay. First of all, plants we have divided into two main parts. Okay. This part. Is known as root, and the part above the ground is known as shoot part. Okay, we have divided into two main parts. Now, in the shoot part, we can see many things attached to the shoot part. The main part of the shoot is the main part. Stem is the main part of the shoot. Okay, in the stem you can see the leaves is attached. This is leaves or leaf to right. Okay, this is fruit. This is birds.
Part of plant.
know what is the germination. Repeat after me. The process by which seed grow into a new plant in the presence of air, water and warmth is called germination. So what is the germination? It is the process. Okay. So what is germination? It is the process. The process. What process? By which seeds, you can see here is a seed. Okay. By which seeds grow into a new plant. You can see this seed is grown into a new plant in presence of air, water and warmth. This seed need air also, water also and warmth also. Okay. Little warmth they need, not need sunlight. When warmth they need, air they need and water they need. Then this seed grow into a new plant. This process is only known as germination. So the process by which seeds grow into a new plant in the presence of air, water and warmth is called germination. The process by which seeds grow into a new plant in presence of air, water and warmth is called germination. What in presence of? You have to learn this. In presence of air, water and warmth. Okay. And then you have to show with the help of diagram. So what you will draw here, this is the, I have shown the surface of the mud here. Okay, this is the mud, downside part. And then here is the seed. Seed get air, water and warmth. Then you can see that one part is going down to the earth and one part is growing upside of the earth. Means upside of the ground you can say. Okay, soil. Now you can see there is a two leaf type structure comes out from that plant, that seed, and this is root like structure which is going down. Again this grows up and this root part also grows well and going down side of the soil. And now the third leaf is also comes to this plant. Okay, and then at last it started growing only. And then it will grow and it will become like this. Okay, so from the seed you can see that new plants grow. Okay, and this new plants, means small plant, which is known as seedling, this seedling grows into a plant. Okay, so this is only process of germination. Now children, what is the process of photosynthesis? And then we will draw the diagram of two types of root here. Okay. Now root is also of two types. Okay, this root is of two types, tap root and fibrous root. Some plants like that mango and neem, the main thick root will grow from the end of the stem. Okay, one main thick root will grow and then many secondary root will grow from that main root. Okay, that type of root is known as tap root. And in some plants, at the end of the stem, you can see this is a stem. Okay, and at the end of the stem, many thin small roots will grow from the stem. You can see many root is there, but all are thin, not thick. You can not see any thick root like this here. So this type of root is known as fibrous root. Now this is the plant. I have to show the process of photosynthesis. For the in the process of photosynthesis, who prepare the food? Which is the kitchen of the plant or food factory of the plant? That is leaf. Okay, it is of green color. The screen is of green color. Why it is of green color? Due to presence of one green pigment called chlorophyll. So there is chlorophyll here. That's why it is of green color. Okay, these leaves is having chlorophyll. Okay. This chlorophyll traps the sunlight. Okay. So in the process of photosynthesis, we need the light of the sun. Okay. So from here they are getting sunlight. Okay, this leaves. And from here they are getting water and minerals. Root is only absorbing the water from here now. They are absorbing the water and they are sending to the leaf. So from here they are getting water and minerals. Okay. And it is going upside, this water and minerals. Going to the leaves, okay? And then they are receiving that carbon dioxide from the air. So this carbon dioxide is coming. They are taking carbon dioxide to the tiny pores called stomata. So here it will be carbon dioxide begins to by CO2. So they are taking CO2, okay, carbon dioxide. And like that they are preparing the food in presence of sunlight, carbon dioxide and water. In presence of sun and with water and carbon dioxide. And after the preparing food, there is a byproduct, okay, oxygen they release, and that oxygen they transfer to the atmosphere again. So now this oxygen is going back to the atmosphere, okay. Here the carbon dioxide is coming inside and oxygen is going outside. So oxygen becomes show by O2. Or if you have plates, you can write here carbon dioxide getting inside and oxygen getting outside, okay? Going outside. So if anyone will say, draw the diagram to explain photosynthesis, you will draw the simple diagram. You will draw one plant, then you have to show here sunlight, carbon dioxide is they are taking in, oxygen they are giving out in the process of photosynthesis, and there is a chlorophyll present in the leaves, and water and minerals they are getting from the soil by the help of root, and with all these things they are preparing food. This is only the diagram of photosynthesis. Okay. Now children, if anyone will say you to draw the diagram of two edible root. You know what is the edible root? Carrot, radish. So you will draw the diagram of carrot and radish. You know how to draw carrot and radish. Then you have to draw the diagram of edible stem. You will draw one potato and sugar cane. These are edible stem, okay? Then draw the diagram of edible leaves. Edible means which we can eat, which we are eating. Okay. So spinach, mint, cabbage, these diagrams you can draw. For edible flower, you can draw cauliflower, broccoli. Okay. For edible fruits, you can draw any vegetables like that, ladyfinger, brinjal, or apple, mango, guava, all are fruit only. Okay. So like that you can draw the diagram whatever will ask to you. You draw the diagram of food factory, what you will draw? Leaf you will draw. Okay. So thank you children. Have a nice day.